أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد. Now we come to سورة الصف. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سبح لله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لم تقولون ما لا تفعلون. كبر مقتا عند الله أن تقولوا ما لا تفعلون. إن الله يحب الذين يقاتلون في سبيله صفا كأنهم بنيان مرصوص. صدق الله العظيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. These 10 surahs, Madani surahs, from Hadid to Tahrim, they are in the form of 5 pairs. And this is the central pairs, Surah Al-Saff and Surah Al-Jum'ah. Because we have 4 surahs before them, 2 pairs. 4 surahs after them, 2 pairs. This is the central surah. Surah Hadid started with the glory of Allah, but Surah Mujadala without its mentioning. This was one pair. Surah Al-Hashr started, سَبَّحَ لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. But Surah Al-Mumtahina without it. It was the second pair. But now this central and third pair, it is unique in this sense that both the surahs are starting with this mention of glorification of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by everything in the universe. Moreover, change of tense. Surah Al-Saff starts with سَبَّحَ لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَهُوَ الْعَزِيدُ الْحَكِيمِ. Exactly the same ayah with which Surah Al-Hashr started. And then the next Surah Al-Jum'ah, it will start يُسَبِّحُ لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Here it is past tense and there it is مُزَارِع. And مُزَارِع in Arabic grammar, it covers the past, the present and the future both tenses. So it covers the whole time. And مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ covers whole existence, total universe. Universe is not a sufficient word. Total existence is مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. So now it has, so to say, engulfed everything, encompassed everything, and all the time. Everything in this universe has been glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from ever, is glorifying at every moment, will continue to glorify forever. Now the rebuke or the reproach, a very important, I told you in the very beginning, common feature of these surahs. Ya ayyuha allazeena amanu lima taquluna ma la taf'alun. O you who profess to believe, why do you say what you do not do? This difference, this gap between saying something, doing something else. If you look to your utterances, well, they are very high. And if you look to your behavior, deeds, they are very low. Well, this gap, kabura maqtan indallah, it's most hateful in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, an taqulu ma la taf'alun, that you should say what you do not do. This maqt is more than wrath. You know, anger, you become angry with a friend when he does something which you never expected of him. Or your son, he has done something which you never expected, so you are angry. Then wrath is a higher form of anger. But there comes a stage when you have no hopes from some person. So now there is no anger. In Urdu we call it bezari. Bezar ho jana. No hope. So this is a higher level than wrath or anger. Naqt. This word has appeared in Surah An-Nisa. Sa Maqta. People in the Jahiliyyah period, before Islam came in Arabia, they used to marry their mothers, not real mothers, stepmothers. A person has died, he has left four wives. Now, the eldest son, he is the inheritor. Anyhow, all the four have not born him. He was born by one mother. All the three he takes as wives. Very bad, very bad. For this word appears in Surah An-Nisa. So that is the same word. Kabura maqtan indallahi an taqulu ma la taf'alun. Now the fourth ayah is the climax. If you are a true mu'min, it means you claim that you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبًّا لِلَّهِ. That is absolutely necessary. That is logical result. Real iman, total obedience with extreme love. These two things go to make ibadah, for which we have been created. وَمَا خَرَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. Now if you love Allah, let Allah tell you, Allah loves whom? Inna Allah yuhibbu allazeena yuqatiluna fi sabeelihi saffan kaannahum bunyanun marsoos. Indeed Allah loves those of his servants and bondsmen who go to war for his cause, go to fight in his way, in ranks which are so well compacted, so solid, as if it's a reinforced structure. No cracks. So this is the highest virtue in Islam. It's very important. Every philosophy has a concept of highest virtue. What's the highest virtue according to Islam? That you go to war for the cause of Allah. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الَّذِينَ يُقَاتِلُونَ فِي سَبِيلِهِ صَفًّا كَأَنَّهُمْ بُنْيَانٌ مَرْصُوصٌ. Now you peep down in your hearts and search your souls. Are you ready for that? And this is what I told you. In 14 ayat, the purpose of the advent of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is clearly given. Why we have sent Muhammad? And then a very forcefully, very passionate call to those who say we believe in Allah and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to devote themselves to fulfill that cause. So simple. So the climax of that is to go to war in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now in the next four ayat, there is a mention of the history of Bani Israel. They were the former Muslim Ummah. Just recall the position that has been given to you now. They had that position for 2,000 long years. From 1400 BC to 610 AD, 2010 years, they were the representatives of Allah on earth. But what they did, this should be a sign of fear for you. Maybe you also tread on the same path. وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَى لِقَوْمِهِ يَا قَوْمِ لِمَ تُؤْذُونَنِي وَقَدْ تَعْلَمُونَ أَنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ. Just recall. When Musa said to his people, Oh my people, why do you annoy me? وَقَدْ تَعْلَمُونَ. You very well know. أَنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ. I am the messenger of Allah to you. We accept me as the messenger of Allah. then you disobey me, you quarrel with me, you don't do what I ask you to do. And this is the situation actually, the whole thing is discussed in Surah Al-Ma'idah. When after the book was given to Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, and now this Bani Israel, which was a nation up till now, has now become the Ummah, Muslim Ummah. The Ummah actually is on the basis of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now they were sent to go enter Palestine and conquer it. But to conquer Palestine, they had to go to war. And if you go to war, you have to risk your lives. They flatly refused. فَزَبَنْتَ وَرَبُّكَ فَقَاتِلَا إِنَّهَا هُنَا قَاعِدُونَ Go you, Musa, and your Lord. And let me add, take your staff also with you. You have shown so many miracles with this staff. Go and expel those people from that land. Then we shall enter. Now the condition, the emotional and psychic condition of Musa alayhi salam at that was of waqt, bezari. That is why he prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. رَبِّ إِنِّي لَا أَمْلِكُ إِلَّا نَفْسِي وَأَخِي فَفْرُقْ بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَ الْقَوْمِ الْفَاسِخِينَ Oh my Lord, I don't have any power over anybody else except myself and my brother Harun. And the whole community is giving flat reply. Now please, I want that I should be separated from them. I don't want to stay with them now. This was the bezari, waqt of Musa, who so much loved his nation that when a Qibti was quarreling with an Israeli and he had struck him with his fist and done away with him. But now, this is the waqt. So he said, why do you annoy me? Why do you pinch me? فَلَمَّا زَاغُوا أَزَاغَ اللَّهُ قُلُوبَهُمْ When they took the wrong turn, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made also their hearts turn in that wrong direction. This is most important ayah of the Quran regarding this law under which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives guidance or leads astray to anybody. If you turn towards right, Allah will help you. If you take a wrong turn, well, Allah will make your heart also deviant. First, this decision is yours. When they took the wrong turn, they swerved from the right path. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused their hearts also swerve in the same direction. وَاللَّهُ لَا يَهْدِ الْقَوْمَ الظَّالِمِينَ Allah doesn't guide such evildoers. And what does it mean? Allah does not forcibly guide. This is not the law of Allah. He neither forcibly guides nor forcibly sends astray anybody. If he uses force, caution, then there is no question of test. خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لَيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا No. The choice is yours and it's free choice. Whichever way you take, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make that way easier for you. So that was the behavior of Bani Israel with Hazrat Musa. Now the second phase of the history of Bani Israel. The second messenger who came to them. وَإِذْ قَالَ عِيسَى بْنَ مَرْيَمَ عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمَ And when Isa, son of Maryam, said, Ya Bani Israel, O children of Israel, Inni Rasulullah ilaykum, Verily, I am the messenger of Allah towards you. Musaddiqan lima bayna yadayya minat Torah. And I confirm whatever is present before me from Torah. Maybe some of Torah has been lost. Because 600 years before the coming of Isa, the real Torah had vanished. When Nebuchadnezzar destroyed Jerusalem in the year 587 BC, after that the real Torah is not there. So maybe some of it is lost. But whatever of the Torah is present before me, I confirm it. On the one hand, I confirm Moses and Torah, and on the other, وَمُبَشِّرًا بِرَسُولٍ يَأْتِي مِنْ بَعْدِهِ And I have brought to you the glad tidings of a messenger who will come after me. اسمه أحمد. His name is Ahmad. صلى الله عليه وسلم. This is one of the five names that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said. I have five names. And this is a hadith in Bukhari from Jubair ibn Mut'im رضي الله تعالى عنه. أنا محمد، أنا أحمد، أنا الماهي، أنا الحاشر، أنا العاقب. My name is Muhammad, also Ahmad, also Mahi. Mahi, who will eliminate the falsehood from the world. Hashir, who will gather the people. First to be resurrected will be Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And all the others will be resurrected after him. And Al-Aqib, I am the last of all the messengers. So this is his name. فَلَمَّا جَاءُوا بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ But when Isa came to them with the most glittering miracles of the history of all the messengers of Allah, the biggest miracles were given to Hazrat Masih alayhi salatu wasalam. But what did they say? The ulama of Bani Israel, قَالُوا هَذَا سِحْرٌ مُبِينٌ They said, this is clear and manifest and plain sorcery and nothing else. Rejected him. وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ افْتَرَى عَلَى اللَّهِ الْكَذِبَ وَهُوَ يُدْعَى إِلَى الْإِسْلَامِ And who is more evildoer than the person who forges a lie against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while he is called towards al-Islam? A messenger is calling them to Islam. Isa called them to Islam. Allahu Rabbi wa Rabbukum, fa'buduh, hadha siratun mustaqim. But they said, this is sorcery. The miracles that Allah gave, they said it is sorcery. Wallahu la yahdi al-qawma al-zalimin. Allah does not guide such evil doers, such unjust people. Again that word, forcibly. It's not his rule to forcibly guide such a people towards the right path. Now this fourth ayah of this second. First four ayat, the address was to the Muslims. A sort of reproachment, a sort of rebuke. Then you see backward, look to the history of your former Muslim Ummah. It shouldn't be that you should also meet the same fate. But now this fourth ayah in the second part. يُرِيدُونَ لَيُطْفَئُوا نُورَ اللَّهِ بِأَفْوَاهِهِمْ And this يُرِيدُونَ actually, it denotes only the Jews. These Jews, these Bani Israel. Now the third phase has come and Muhammad has been sent by us sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a messenger to all the people of the world. But now they are enemies of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they want to extinguish the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by blowing their mouths, through their mouths. This is the character of Jews which has not changed. This was the character at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Always hatching conspiracies, instigating others, oh you come out, you attack, we shall help you from inside. The worst enemies. And that has continued throughout history. It's a fact that the Muslims gave them refuge in Spain. They were persecuted badly by the Christians in Europe. But Muslims gave them respect, rest, everything. Ben Gurion has said that Muslim Spain was the golden era of our diaspora. But then, they were the people who conspired and instigated the Christians to launch the Crusades. It was instigated by them. Although when Crusades started, then they were also beaten along with the Muslims. But originally they were the instigators. And today now, Zionism, especially when they have conquered the Christian world, they are the worst enemies. They are hatching plots. And that time is not very far off when there will be a final confrontation between the deen of Allah, deen of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the world of Judaism and Christianity. In the forefront will be Christians, but actually at the back and controlling them and directing them will be the Jews. And that Armageddon or Al-Mulhabatul Uzma is not very far off. It's going to come very soon now. يُرِيدُونَ لَيُطْفِئُوا نُورَ اللَّهِ بِأَفْوَاهِهِمْ. They intend to extinguish the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with their mouths, that is by blowing. وَاللَّهُ مُتِمَّ نُورِهِ وَلَوْ كَرِهَ الْكَافِرُونَ. And Allah has decided that He will perfect His light. Although this might be not pleasant, not liked by the unbelievers. This perfection of light will be when? When Islam will become dominant over the whole of this globe. The light essentially was perfected at the time of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But you know, the area it covered was not the whole of the globe. But this light is to shine over the whole of the globe according to the prophecies of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now this ayah number 9. This is not only the central axis of this surah. This plus ayah number 25 of Suratul Hadid, they are the axis of the whole of Quran. That ayah number 25 Suratul Hadid has slightly changed in the case of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you recall, لَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا رُسُلَنَا. This was in plural. A general rule. لَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا رُسُلَنَا بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ وَأَنزَلْنَا مَاهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْمِيزَانِ لَيَقُومَ النَّاسُ بِالْقِسْطِ. Now this general principle, when applied to the advent of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is the form. هُوَ الَّذِي أَرْسَلَ رَسُولَهُ. Now this is singular. It is He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has sent His messenger, that is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, بِالْهُدَى وَدِينِ الْحَقِّ. Now, bayyanat, the miracles. In case of Muhammad, the miracle is also Quran. So, kitab and bayyanat are merged into this book. بِالْهُدَى, al-huda, this Quran. And the balance has perfected with the advent of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the form of Deenul Haqq. Now it's a full system of life, a full political, socio-economic order. It is He who has sent His messenger with two things, with the total guidance, the final guidance, the complete guidance, that is Quran, and the Deen-e Haq, the just political, socio-economic system of life. What for? لَيُزْهِرَهُ عَلَى الدِّينِ كُلِّ. So that He makes it dominant over all the systems of life. وَلَوْ كَرِهَ الْمُشْرِكُونَ. Although the associators with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of false gods or false deities, they will never like it. But it is duty to do it. So now Muhammad was not only a bearer of glad tidings and a warner, but also a revolutionary role was assigned to him. We have that in Surah Ash-Shura. أُمِرْتُ لِعَادِلَ بَيْنَكُمْ. I have been sent to establish justice amongst you. And all our passengers we send for this purpose, لَيَقُومَ النَّاسُ بِالْقِسْطِ, so that people should abide by justice. And now that justice has been perfected, الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمْ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا, in the form of دِينُ الْحَقِّ. Now to establish it over the whole human life, not a part of it, without any exception. This is the role assigned to him. This is the mission given to him. And for this now, those who claim that we believe in Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, a very passionate call is being issued to them. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا هَلْ أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَىٰ تِجَارَةٍ تُنْجِيكُمْ مِنْ عَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ. Oh, you who profess to believe, should I guide you to a trade the profit of which will be that you will be saved from the painful chastisement of the hereafter. I told you this word trade is used at many places in the Quran, simple to understand. If you are in a business, you must have some capital, and then you have to work. In the same way, what for? You want some profit. In the same way, you will have to enter into a business. You will have to spend your money, your belongings, your wealth, and also your hard work, even your life. If you want to be saved from the painful chastisement of the day of the hereafter. Now what does it mean? If you don't enter into this bargain, and still you hope that you will have salvation in the hereafter, it's your wishful thinking. Allah doesn't guarantee it. It's a conditional thing. You can get salvation, but you have to do this business. Otherwise, this ayah becomes meaningless, futile. And what is that business? تُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. Have real faith in Allah and His Messenger, who have been addressed, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. And they are being told to have real belief. You have the belief, but your belief is only at the tip of your tongues. It should go down, sink down into the depths of your hearts. وَتُجَاهِدُونَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ بِأَمْوَالِكُمْ وَأَنفُسِكُمْ. And exert your utmost, strive your utmost in the way of Allah, to make the deen of Allah supreme. What is the way of Allah? لَيُزْهِرَهُ عَلَى الدِّينِ كُلِّهِ. To make the deen of Allah supreme, this is the way of Allah. To exert your utmost. And you have two things, بِأَمْوَالِكُمْ, with your belongings, وَأَنفُسِكُمْ, and your lives. ذَٰلِكُمْ خَيْرُ لَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. This is better for you if you know. Now just recall ayah number 15 of Surah Al-Hujurat. We had a comprehensive definition of who is a real mu'min. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ ثُمَّ لَمْ يَرْتَابُوا وَجَاهَدُوا بِأَمْوَالِهِمْ وَأَنفُسِهِمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الصَّادِقُونَ. Verily the true mu'mins are only those who believe in Allah and the Messenger, then doubt not. Yaqeen. Conviction. And they strive in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with their belongings and lives. Only such people are true when they claim that they are mu'min. So there can be no iman without jihad fi sabilillah. And here, there can be no salvation without jihad fi sabilillah. If even now we say that jihad fi sabilillah is not farz, it's not obligatory, it's not ordained on us, I'm at a loss to understand. That means we are belying Quran. Quran says there's no real iman without jihad. There's no salvation possible without jihad. يَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. Now what will happen if you do it? Allah will forgive you your shortcomings, number one. وَيُدْخِلْكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَعْتِ الْأَنْهَارِ. And will make you enter the garden underneath which rivers will be flowing. وَمَسَاكِنَ طَيِّبَةً فِي جَنَّاتِ عَدْنٍ. And grant you very pleasant dwellings in the gardens of perpetual bliss. ذَلِكَ الْفَضْلُ الْعَظِيمُ. This is the greatest kamyabi. This is the greatest success. It's very meaningful here. Because another thing is mentioned after that. وَأُخْرَى تُحِبُّونَهَا. Another thing which you love. And that is, نَصْرٌ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَفَتْحٌ قَرِيبٌ. Help from Allah and a near victory. What does it mean? These things have no importance in the eyes of Allah. In the eyes of Allah, the real success is the success of the hereafter. Whether in this world you succeed or not succeed, it's irrelevant. If you have done whatever you could do, you are successful. Nothing might have happened. No revolution might have appeared. You might not have seen the success, your struggle crowned with success, no harm. If you have done whatever you could do, if you have spent everything that you had, you are successful. That is the success. It is an additional thing. This Allah grants sometimes, and sometimes doesn't grant. So many prophets of Allah went from this world without any visible, tangible success. So were they failures? No. They were successful. The nations failed, and then they were destroyed. Very important. For people who take this way, this path actually, they should stop thinking about success. Leave it. If Allah wishes, it will come. If no, we don't care. We have to care for whether I am doing whatever I can do, or I am sparing something, keeping back. That is the main issue. If I put everything, then I am successful. Now this, actually, this surah was revealed in the year 6th after Hijrah. And this position had matured after the Battle of Ahzab, trenches, Khandaq. I told you that after the Battle of Ahzab, the Prophet had told the Muslims, لَن تَغْزُوكُمْ قُرَيْشْ بَعْدَ عَامِكُمْ حَذَا وَلَكِنَّكُمْ تَغْزُونَهُمْ. Now Quraysh will never be able to come and attack you. Now you will go towards them. So now the Muslims as a community, as an ummah, the companions of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had passed that test when they stood fast in the Battle of Ahzab. Though they had passed, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving them the glad tidings. Now, the help of Allah is near, and very soon, success will kiss your feet. So this is a particular, a time-tied phenomenon. Not always. Maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is still trying you. But at that time, this was the time for this glad tiding. And that is why, that very year, the Prophet went for Umrah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and then the Treaty of Hudaybiyah was concluded, and Allah declared, Inna fatahna laka fatham mubina. The gates of success opened. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu kunu ansar Allah. O you who believe, or profess to believe, be helpers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What do you mean? Allah is weak? No. But he is testing you that this way. If you help his deen, if you want to make his deen supreme, you are. By his blessing, he is taking you to be his helpers. Kama qala Isa ibn Maryam lil Hawariyin. Just as Isa, son of Maryam, had said to his disciples, Man ansari ilallah, who are my helpers towards Allah? Now this is helping Allah and helping the messenger. Kunu ansar Allah, be helpers to Allah. And Hazrat Isa said, be my helpers towards Allah. The same two words came in the ayah of number 25 of Suratul Hadid. لَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا رُسُلَنَا بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ وَأَنزَلْنَا مَعَهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْمِيزَانَ لِيَقُومَ النَّاسُ بِالْقِسْطِ وَأَنزَلْنَا الْحَدِيدَ فِيهِ بَأْسٌ شَدِيدٌ وَمَنَافِعُ لِلنَّاسِ وَلَيَعْلَمَ اللَّهُ مَنْ يَنْصُرُهُ وَرُسُلَهُ بِالْغَيْبِ. Allah wants to see who are his faithful servants who help him and his messengers. So this is the help to Allah, because this deen is Allah's deen. We want to make it supreme. And this is the help to messenger, because to make it supreme was primarily the mission assigned to the messenger. So help to Allah and help to the messenger. قَالَ الْحَوَارِيُّونَ نَحْنُ أَنصَارُ اللَّهِ. The disciples of Isa said, we are the helpers of Allah. فَآمَنَ الطَّائِفَةُ مِنْ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ وَكَفَرَ الطَّائِفَةُ. Then the children of Israel got divided. A group of them believed in Isa, and the other group, they denied him, rejected him. فَأَيَّدْنَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَرَادُوا بِهِمْ. But then we helped those who had believed against their enemies. فَأَصْبَحُوا ظَاهِرِينَ. And in the long run, they were the triumphants, they were the dominants. But please note, this thing took 300 years. Not immediately. Christians were badly persecuted by the Jews as well as the Romans. But there's no doubt, the followers of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, they were very persevering, very persevering, very persevering. But then in the year 300 of Christian era, Emperor Constantine of Rome, he converted to Christianity. And the whole empire converted to Christianity. Now they were dominant. Now they started persecuting the Jews. And they were worst persecuted community at that time. From that time till the Muslims enter Europe. Now we come to Surah Al-Jumu'ah. I have already mentioned, this is a pair, and the most central pair of these 10 surahs. In Surah Al-Saf, three things are very clear. Number one, why was Muhammad sent, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? هُوَ الَّذِي أَرْسَلَ رَسُولَهُ بِالْهُدَى وَدِينِ الْحَقِّ لِيُنْزِرَهُ عَلَى الدِّينِ كُلِّهِ. Number two, if you are a true mu'min, if you want salvation in the hereafter, you have to make jihad for that cause. You have to do it. No escape. Number three, this jihad can reach the level of qital. Don't think it will always be a dawah only and a passive resistance. No, no, no. It is bound to reach that level and you will be required to lay down their lives in the battlefield. If you don't do it, don't hope for salvation. If you do it, then Allah will forgive you and make you enter paradise. And if you are not doing it, then kabura maqtan indallahi an taqulu ma la taf'alu. Then stop saying that you are mu'min. Stop saying that you believe in Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Don't say you believe in Allah and his messenger. Otherwise, saying something else and doing something else, it is not giving you any credit. It is adding to the discredit every time. Now the question arises, where from to get those people who will do this jihad in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? First of all, there should be man force, man power. For that's what is the basic methodology of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the topic of Surah Al-Jumu'ah. How he gathered people, how he trained them. That was most important. Unless you have a party group of most committed people, ready to sacrifice everything, ready to lay down their lives, how can you proceed? But where to get these people from? Do they grow somewhere? Are there some trees? The fruit of which are these people? How? Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Yusabbihu lillahi ma fis samawati wa ma fil ard. Lahul mulk. Al-Malik al-Quddus al-Aziz al-Hakim. This is the second place in the whole of Quran where four names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala come consecutively. The first was also in this series, Surah Al-Hadid, Huwa al-Awwalu wal-Akhiru wal-Zahiru wal-Batin. Here without wow, Al-Malik al-Quddus al-Aziz al-Hakim. Everything is glorifying and will continue to glorify forever, whether that thing is in the heavens or in the earth. Glorifying whom? Allah, who is the King, the Sovereign, the Holy, the Mighty, and the Wise. هو الذي بعث في الأميين رسولا منهم. It is he who has raised from among the unlettered ones a messenger from among themselves. What does this messenger do? Now this is the crucial ayah. يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة. These four terms are very basic, very essential. Repeated four times in the Quran. In the prayer of Ibrahim and Ismail, رَبَّنَا وَبَعْثْ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِّنْهُمْ يَتْلُوَ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِكَ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ. Then when Allah says, we have granted the prayer of Ibrahim and Ismail, and advent of Muhammad is actually the manifestation of the prayer of Ibrahim and Ismail alayhi salam. كَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا فِيكُمْ رَسُولًا مِّنْكُمْ يَتْلُو عَلَيْكُمْ آيَاتِنَا وَيُزَكِّيكُمْ وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ. Then for the third time in Surah Al Imran, لَقَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذْ بَعَثَ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِنْ أَنفُسِهِمْ يَتْلُو عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ. And for the fourth time here. Now this is the basic methodology. How he changed people. First, recite unto them the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is like a magnet. The first experiment that we did in fifth class, I think, science class, science laboratory, there's a mixture of iron filings and wood pieces. How to separate the two? A mixture. Take each and one, no. Take a magnet. Move it. The iron filings will stick to the magnet and the wood will remain. This Quran is the magnet. To it immediately get attached the people whose spirits in them have not died, whose nature is still salim, not perverted. Healthy nature, they will come. So this is the magnet. You in the society, you go on reciting Quran. As we found in Inna fi zalika la zikra liman kana lahu qalbun aw alqa sam'a wa huwa shahid. They will come. They will come and gather around you. Now, the second task is you zakkihim, purify them. If they have some impurities in them, purify them. What are the impurities? Some bad habits may be there. Some wrong deeds, purify. Some worldly ambitions might be there. Purify the hearts. From the worldly ambitions. And now, when they are purified from within, and within has two aspects, purification of the brain, that is the thought. Purification of the thought. And purification of the intentions. Niyya, that is in the heart. When this purification has taken place, now teach them the book and the hikmah. Three stages. يَتْلُوْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ. This was the basic methodology of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He continued this work for 12 long years at Makkah. So about 150 people gathered around him, purified them, organized them, taught them the book and the wisdom. Now those were the people who were in the vanguard for jihad fi sabilillah. For 2 years, no Ansari was included in jihad fi sabilillah. It was a purely, exclusively Muhajir phenomenon. Ansaris were called only at the Battle of Badr. The 8 expeditions before Badr, they were exclusively Muhajir phenomenon. This was the group prepared by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam through this process of yatlu alayhim ayatihi wa yuzakkihim wa yuallimuhum al-kitab wa al-hikmah. وَإِنْ كَانُوا مِنْ قَبْلُ لَفِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ. Verily, before that they were in a very manifest error. وَآخَرِينَ مِنْهُمْ. And we have raised this messenger of ours, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not only for these unlettered people, others also, who will be eventually with them. But they have not up till now joined them. Because he is sent for the whole of humanity. After the Arabs, the Iranians will come. The Coptics will come. The Berbers will come. The, Turkistanis will come. The Sindhis will come. The Indians will come. So these are also. He was sent for them also. But primarily, because he was himself from among the Ummiyin. So his primary advent was for the Ummiyin. He prepared an Ummah whose nucleus was consisting of the Ummiyin. But then, the electrons, one after the other, coming and, circumambulating that nucleus. So this is the constitution of this Ummah. وَآخَرِينَ مِنْهُمْ لَمَّا يَلْحَقُوا بِهِمْ They have not joined them up till now. وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ Definitely, he is almighty and the wise. I have told you before, these two names of Allah are repeated in these surahs most, recurrently. Al-Aziz, Al-Hakim. ذَلِكَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ يُؤْتِيهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ This is the bounty of Allah. He grants it to himself, to whomsoever he wishes. وَاللَّهُ ذُو الْفَضْلِ الْعَظِيمِ And definitely Allah is of infinite bounty. Now again, just as we had the example of the former Muslim Ummah, the Jews, the Bani Israel, now again, example. O Muslims, you are today being given Quran. They were given Torah. What they did with Torah, see that you don't do that with Quran. مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ حُمِّلُوا التَّوْرَاةَ ثُمَّ لَمْ يَحْمِلُوهَا The similitude of those who were entrusted with the responsibility of Torah, but they didn't carry it out. كَمَثَلِ الْحِمَارِ يَحْمِلُوا أَسْفَارًا That is like a donkey laden with books. On a donkey you might load, volumes of philosophy or volumes of science. To what avail? For him. In the same way, an ummah, which has been entrusted with the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, doesn't fulfill its duties regarding it. I mentioned one of my basic pamphlets, Muslimano par Qur'an-e-Majeed ke huquq, what the Muslims owe to Qur'an. It is present in English also, Urdu also, Persian also, Arabic also. A very bad and wretched is the example of the people who belie the revelations of Allah. Now this is takzeeb. Did the Jews ever say that Torah was not sent by Allah? Never. But this is the practical belying. When you don't act upon it, that is, you are belying it with your action. Had you really believed this is the word of Allah, you had acted upon it. This means you are saying something else, doing something else. Your attitude denotes something else. وَاللَّهُ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الظَّالِمِينَ And Allah doesn't forcibly guide such evildoers. And what is the reason of this attitude of a Muslim Ummah? The Muslim Ummah, when it is entrusted with a high mission, instead of looking to the responsibilities of that mission, they take pride that we are the Muslims, and we are the Muslim Ummah, and we are the Ummah of the Prophet, of Messenger. On this pride they think that they are entitled to salvation, whatever they do. The salvation in the hereafter is their birthright. They must get it. So then, if this salvation is your birthright, what's the need of doing something? Why to differentiate between halal and haram, permissible and forbidden? Why? Do whatever you like. You will get the salvation anyhow. This is the reason. قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ هَادُوا إِنْ زَعَمْتُمْ أَنَّكُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ لِلَّهِ مِنْ دُونِ النَّاسِ Say, oh, you who have become Jews, If you assert that you are alone Allah's friends apart from the rest of the mankind, فَتَمَنَّوُ الْمَوْتَ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ, then you should long for death. If you have real love with someone, you want to meet him, not to be keep away from him. If you love Allah, and if you really think that Allah loves you, then you should die and go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا يَتَمَنَّوْنَهُ أَبَدًا, and they are not going to long for this death. بِمَا قَدَّمَتْ يَدِيهِمْ, because of the deeds that their hands have forwarded for them. وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِالظَّالِمِينَ, Allah very well knows these evildoers. قُلِدَ الْمَوْتَ الَّذِي تَفِرُونَ مِنْهُ, say to them, the death from which you flee, فَإِنَّهُ مَلَاقِيكُمْ, surely it will encounter you, it will come and meet you. You might be running away from the death, but it will come before you. ثُمَّ تُرَدُّونَ إِلَىٰ عَلِمِ الْغَيْبِ وَالشَّهَادَةِ, then you will be returned to Allah, who is the knower of the seen and the unseen. فَيُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ, and then he will tell you what you had been doing. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, now this process which Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم continued, this يَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِمْ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ, this was then institutionalized in the form of Friday. You know, there were no schools, no colleges, no books, no journals, no video audio tapes. So the only method of education, mass education, public education, was this weekly meeting of the believers. Take bath, change your clothing. If you have some scent, use it. Come to the mosque. And there, some one in the place of the Prophet. The Prophet used to stand on that member. Now someone is standing, this is the member of Rasul, of the Messenger. And he will do the same job. يَتْلُوْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِمْ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ, this was the basic purpose of this Jummah, which later on became a ritual. Nothing. رَهْ گئی رَسْمِ عَزَانْ رُوحِ بِلَالِ نَ رَحِي اور فلسفہ رَهْ گئی تَلْقِينِ غَزَالِ نَ رَحِي, nothing left in it. It's a ritual. That's all. It was actually the greatest system of mass education, adult education, public education. Reminding them. You have been entrusted with a mission. كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ خُرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ تَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنكَرِ. To remind them, that was actually the purpose. Every revolutionary party, even the communists, they used to have their weekly meetings, reviewing their thoughts, their ideologies, so that they remain fresh in their minds, so that they are fully engaged in the struggle. And this is it. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا نُودِيَ لِلصَّلَاةِ مِنْ يَوْمِ الْجُمُعَةِ فَاسْعَوْا إِلَىٰ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَذَرِ الْبَيْعِ, O you who believe, when the call is given for the prayer, congregational prayer, on Friday, that is the Jummah prayer, فَاسْعَوْا إِلَىٰ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ, has to hasten to the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَذَرُ الْبَيْعِ, leave all your trading, everything. ذَلِكُمْ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ, this is good for you if you only know. It was so important that the Prophet said, مَنْ تَرَكَ سَلَاسَ جُمُعَاتٍ بِغَيْرِ عُزْرٍ لَيَخْتِمَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِهِ, whosoever Muslim leaves three Friday prayer sermons, congregations, without attending them, without there being very real cause, why should we seek? There is something else. بغیر عذرن, Allah is sure to seal his heart. لَيَخْتِمَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِهِ, this is so important. فَإِذَا قُضِيَتِ الصَّلَاةُ, when this prayer has been concluded, and the most important part of Jummah is not the prayer, it's the khutbah. Prayer, you know, Zuhr has 4 rakat. And in Juma, there are 2. Prayer-wise, not important. It's the khutbah, actually. Because that is meant for education, renewing the ideology in your minds. So that is the essential part. فَإِذَا قُلِتِ السَّلَاةُ when the prayer have been concluded, فَانْتَشِرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ when you can or you may disperse in the land. وَابْتَغُوا مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ and seek Allah's bounty. And remember, فَاسْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ remember with Allah much so that you are successful. Now a special event is in the background of the last ayah of this Surah Jumu'ah. Once there was much dearth of grains in Medina, no wheat, no rice, etc., etc. And then when the Prophet ﷺ was giving his sermon on Friday, there was the bells started ringing that some caravan is coming. They came to know that a caravan has come, you know, and then there is grain. So if other people go first, maybe they are finished. So most of the people ran and left Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying his sermon. So on this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has, you know, rebuked them. وَإِذَا رَأَوْا تِجَارَةً أَوْ لَهْوًا انْفَضُّوا إِلَيْهَا وَتَرَكُوكَ قَائِمًا And when they saw some merchandise or sports, they dispersed headlong to it, flocked to it eagerly, and left you, O Prophet, standing. It is said that at that time, this Juma sermon was also after the prayer, just as we have in Eids. In Eid al-Fitr, Eid al-Adha, first we pray, and then is the khutbah. That was the case at that time. Then it was changed. Khutbah before Salah. ذَكَرَ اسْمَ رَبِّهِ فَصَلَّى First you take the name of Allah, and then you pray. But at that time, it is one of the opinions. And because people thought, Salah, we have already completed. Now this is khutbah. So there is no great importance of it, we can go. No. But the real essence of Jumu'ah is khutbah. It's the sermon. It has made, khutbah has made Jumu'ah the Jumu'ah. Otherwise there was Zuhr Salah. قُلْ مَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ خَيْرٌ مِّنَ اللَّهُ وَمِنَ التِّجَارَةِ Say to them, whatever is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is much better than the sport and the merchandise. Whatsoever is concerns this world, this is much better which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has for you as reward. وَاللَّهُ خَيْرُ الرَّازِقِينَ And you should have the faith that Allah is the best provider. He will provide for you. Now to sum up this pair of those two surahs. The most important part of Quran regarding the issue of the advent of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Why was Muhammad sent? Not only as a preacher, not only as a teacher, not only as a bearer of glad tidings, not only as a warner, but also to make the deen of Allah supreme, to establish it as a whole politico-socio-economic system. This should be clear, absolutely. And this ayah, هو الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله, it appears 3 times in Quran. Surah Al-Tawbah, then we have read in Surah Al-Fath. The last part is different. وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ الشَّهِيدًا But this part, major part, هُوَ الَّذِي أَرْسَلَ رَسُولَهُ بِالْهُدَى وَدِينِ الْحَقِّ لِيُظْهِرَهُ عَلَى الدِّينِ كُلِّهِ It is repeated without the change of a dot or a letter. So for that, alone Muhammad cannot do it. He needs helpers, faithful helpers, committed, devoted, ready to sacrifice everything, disciplined. In the habit of listening and obeying, moving when commanded, stopping when ordered. So now this work has to be done by those who say, who claim that they believe in Allah and His Messenger. For this purpose, first of all, through Quran, dawah of Quran, dawah through Quran, call people toward this path. Whosoever has some life within him, not the physical life, but the spiritual life, he will respond. Sooner or later, there might be difference, but he will respond. He will accept. Now you have to purify their souls, their characters, their thought, their intentions. Teach them the Book of Allah and the wisdom of that Book of Allah. Now prepare them. And then, when the time comes, challenge kufr and batil and tahut. Challenge it in the battlefield. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if He decrees, His help will come and you will be successful. Otherwise, if you have laid down your life for that cause, you are successful. The real success is the salvation of the hereafter. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Azim wa nafa'ni wa iyyakum bil ayati wa zikrih.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.